Hey everybody, Nate Pace here. So, a while ago I did a video talking about my story with my Asperger's, how I found out and how I deal with it today. If you want to check out that video, I will put it down in the description below, so go check that out if you want. So, in the comments below a while ago, someone asked me, I believe his name was Ocean Cora. I hope I got that name right for you, so if you're watching, I hope I got it right. Thanks, yeah. So, he wrote down if I could make a video about relationship, my relationship dynamics with my Asperger's and such. So, I'm not gonna lie, it's really hard. If you've had trouble dating, getting in relationships, and let's face it, getting in any sorts of relationship is hard, whether it be in a friendship, or whether it be a romantic interest, or anything like that. It's gonna be hard. And for me, it's like 100 times harder, okay? It's like someone has just spawned me up, and they put on the hardcore mode and say, good luck! And it's really hard. The first thing that, when I first meet a girl, I don't know. I always get nervous. I mean, I always get nervous because any person would get nervous when they're talking to someone new. Well, even if you are suave and you are ladies, man, you all have somewhere deep down in you, you got little butterflies in you. And I hear that, and my friend's like, Nate, you're an attractive dude, why do you have trouble meeting with girls? And I'm like, I am an awkward person with Asperger's. I normally need like a lot of help and a lot of cues, like friends, like needing them to be like behind the person that I'm talking to and like give them like little signs like, okay, this is what you say. This is good. Keep going. Oh, she said that. You're gonna have to fix it. All right, say this or do something like this. Or if it's like she has no interest in me at all, it's like, get out now. Or she's just not that into you, bro. Get the fuck out before you get hurt. And I like to say, and a lot of my friends have helped me with that. They have. But it's always interesting when I get into a new relationship with a girl. Because I gotta learn new things about them. Like, what... And I'm pretty sure this is, like, entirely truthful with any new relationship, that you gotta know what they have, know their boundaries and all that. But it's really hard. Because if you don't understand the social cues for that, it's gonna be hard to the wall of balls. I mean, I remember one of the first relations I've had, I basically got her, like, really pissed all the times because I would say these things which I thought they were totally okay and they're totally right, and she would not be okay with that. Oh, that was some fun. That was an interesting time in my life. And I always make it a point in my life to tell them that one moment I need to tell them about it. And I usually get, like, really scared about it. Get really scared to tell them that, hey, I have Asperger's. I hope that doesn't, like, freak you out or anything. And, okay, you're going away now. Okay, bye. Yeah, that's one of my big fears. Comes down to that. And there have been times where that has not happened. I mean, that's just like one of those overblown fantasies that my brain does. You know? And when I get into a relationship with a girl, I always gotta, like, think about their social cues. So that way, in my head, I have my friends, like, projected out in my mind, like, telling me, okay, she said this. This is what you gotta say, okay? And when did I get a pencil? God damn it. My hands just keep picking things up when I'm trying to do this video, so I'm trying not to do that. And with their sarcasm, I'm trying to learn their sarcasm, because for me, sarcasm is a bitch. It's so hard to understand at times, because some people, they're sarcastic like 100% of the time, and their voice can be very sarcastic. And I'm not gonna lie, a lot of my friends are very dryly sarcastic, and it's so painful at times trying to understand if they're being serious or not, because my aspie brain just explodes. So that's always fun to do. And I'm always afraid when I'm in a relationship. I'm always afraid that I'll miss something. That I'll fuck something up because I didn't see the social cue. Or if I didn't particularly... if I didn't understand what they were trying to say. And I just fucked it up. You know? Or if the cues got late, or if the cues misunderstood something. And that's one of my fears when I'm in a relationship, or if I'm with any of my friends. It's always a game of acting for me. I gotta act like I know everything. And I gotta keep myself looking. And I gotta keep studying when every time I'm with them. And if they started developing this new habit, I gotta record it and I gotta remember it. So that way I know that's the way that person is, and that's the way he says these things. And that, and the way he says these things, it's what they mean. And not what it actually sounds like and what you think it is. It sounds understandable, right? And with some relationships, something like that kind of has happened. Or it ended because of that. And it sucks. Because I'm a hopeless romantic. I mean, the flowers, the cuddling, all those cheesy romantic poems. I love that shit. Dude, I love it. It's one of those things that we all desire. And I'm just like, it's a burning passion in my heart. And yeah. It's something like that. And when it comes down to my friends, they always got my back. They've helped me out a lot of times when it comes to, like, new relationships, like, with when I'm talking to, like, different people, or when I'm talking to, when I'm starting a new relationship with a new girl, or something. They're always there, and I'm always learning about their sarcasm. I'm getting more adaptable with people's sarcasm. It's slow, it's a good process. A lot of people in the theater department at MSUM, some of them aren't so sarcastic, but a lot of them are. A lot of them are very sarcastic, and I have to remember that nearly 100% of the time, they are sarcastic. And we have developed this little feature called the sarcasm card. The sarcasm card is basically this with the C, and when they're ever saying something, I go like that, and I see this, and I know they're just being sarcastic. Yeah. And ever meet a girl I want them to know about my tics with my Asperger's. Because I never want them to get hurt if I get into an episode or an Aspie attack. Because those things are not pretty. No. If you have Asperger's or any form of light autism, you know those things are not fun. And you don't want anyone to get in that tornado hell. And yeah, that's why I always make it a point to tell them what's my tics, because I don't want them to get hurt. I guess that's another big fear of mine. That they might get hurt from my Asperger's. I don't want that to happen. I want to make them happy. I want them to enjoy the time that I have with them and all that. I never want my Asperger's to be a thing why it broke or why they got hurt. It's like a big fear. I'm talking about this now, I notice I got a lot of big fears when it comes to it. When it comes to relationships. I guess with any new relationship, you always have these fears. And with these fears, you just gotta learn to, like, use them as, like, little notepads. Little stick pads. Just stick them on your wall. Just glance at them once in a while. Just to remind you of these little things you just gotta be cautious of. And when you have those in mind and you just slowly forget, you just show yourself. And if those people can, like, accept you for who you are and help you work around it and work a way to help your Asperger's or whatever you got to get better. Those are good people. And those people you should stay with you for like the whole rest of your life. Yeah. And as for relationship right now, I am seeing someone right now. She is absolutely awesome. And I really, really like her. And she accepts my Asperger's. Which is very good. And I do like her a lot. She lives kind of far away, so that kind of sucks. But doesn't matter. I'll see her soon sometime. And when that happens, I'm going to flip and I'm going to freak out in a happy glee and do something, some cheesy romantic comedy movie. Yeah. So, that's all I gotta say about that. So, thanks for listening, guys. I really appreciate it. So, like, comment, subscribe, whatever you want to guys do, please do. But any of those things, I greatly appreciate. Tell your friends about it. Show your friends this video. Show your friends or your friends' dogs or whatever. It just makes me happy that you guys out there or someone out there is watching this and they're getting a message out of this. And I hope this video kind of gives you enlightenment or some kind of, like, advice, if you can see it in there, and all that stuff. I hope you guys have a great day, a great life, and a Merry Christmas. Peace and love, everybody.